mentioned the Museum of Modern Art many times tonight, but it is still kind of utopian project because the museum is still not completed. You see here the culture of rendering, so there are two paintings, but only on rendering. So you see on the left, we are in the center of Warsaw, of course. You see on the left, the white shape, it's the future Museum of Modern Art, designed by Tomasz Pfeiffer, American architect, and on the right side, gray building is a theater, new theater. But this project has quite a long and intensive story. The museum is an institution, it was established almost 10 years ago, or 11 years ago. It was established in 2005 as the National Institution of Culture, but as you might already know, there were two architectural competitions, both somehow unsuccessful, because the first was cancelled due to some legal amendments, and in the winner of the second competition, Christian Keres, was in a conflict, in a permanent conflict with the city of Warsaw, and also due to some legal problems and how this project was prepared by our civil servants, it was never completed. So now we have the somehow the third step, the Tomasz Pfeiffer project, which is going to be the construction will start, we hope, in coming year. So, but from this, from our previous somehow experience, and also from the Warsaw Under Construction Festival, we took some things and some ideas to and introduced them to this architecture. For example, the whole space, the grand floor. The grand floor of the museum is really open, and this green shape is the room, the public space for lectures. So this will be the museum, which will be very much somehow connected and having roots in the theory and debate, discussions. But at the moment, and we started here, in the block of apartments. You see here this space in 2008, it was abandoned, there was no glass in some windows. And then the next step, and this is the opening of the first Warsaw Under Construction Festival in 2009, we took this building, the first show, the first, let's say, full scale, the first show we realized then in 2012, but already in 2009 we tried to somehow make some interventions in this building, in the neighborhood, closest neighborhood. Emilia building is now almost demolished, because now it's privatized, but this is the first photo from the 1971 when it was open. It was a huge furniture store in the center of Warsaw, full of such not very modern furniture, but typical for that time, for the 70s. And for us, it was perfect, of course, a little bit as a modernistic maybe ruin or just open space for the museum and its temporary headquarters and temporary needs. So we were investigating some elements of the building, looking at old plans, and using it also for this for our shows. You see some historical shows, organized in the media. But I was asked to tell you tonight some project about some projects which are related to the cities, and our museum takes care also of the Brudno sculpture park. This park is located in the kind of satellite housing estates in Warsaw, far from the center, but we have some, we are installing the museum is every year we keep installing there some sculptures, interventions, workshops, actions. And the park was inspired by a couple of Hammer and a group of artists. This is Toguna by Fudala, African artist. The kind of next step, another story, is the Warsaw Under Construction Festival, which is focused on the city, but we were asked in 2009 to curate a design festival, for Warsaw, and we started to think what it could be and what would we need in this city, and we said that design is not, it's definitely not the first need of Warsaw, because the city is somehow it has many problems which were somehow caused and which were provoked by the neoliberal change in the city. So with this festival we were traveling around the city in many locations. This is, for example, Warsaw School of Economics, and in this kind of school of Polish Leszek Balcerowicz and Polish neoliberal politician, let's say circles, we political circles, we installed there an exhibition showing those social and urban subjects which are somehow deleted or erased from the this neoliberal discourse. Of course, we were collaborating with many artists, Cyprian Gajard, Jasiek Smaga, David Malikowicz, Kasia Przezwańska, Daniela Bram, Ariel Schlesinger, many, many projects for already 9 years. And this is maybe important drawing by Daniela Bram from Berlin, because it is somehow showing our somehow questions or problems behind it, or the questions we were posing on the beginning of the festival. So how this neoliberal situation of the city and country in the transition after communism is visible in the urban problems, and very often during the festival we were touching the problem of modern architecture or old urban fabric which was demolished or occupied or transformed during the transition. So you see here, for example, such an important building. It is late modernist railway station, central railway station in Warsaw. But in this project, this is, for example, 2013, we were asking also about the responsibility of architects, of the circles of architects designing the city, or collaborating with the neoliberal system, or fighting or struggling with it. For example, here you see in the black boxes you see the documents which the architect in Warsaw, the architectural office, needs to somehow sent to the public bureaucracy, and all of those boxes, they are needed only for one building. So there are 150 packets of documents for only one office building. This is Jens Architectural Office and Agora Buildings documentation. And this year we were digging in the housing policy and showing housing as an important problem in Poland. Housing, which is never somehow realized or never finished or never somehow successful as a public program in Poland. And you see here typical Polish housing, typical also maybe for kind of American dream and housing in suburbs, housing which is based on the logic of also on the market, of the development based on the bank of the programs like the mortgage loans and also again this neoliberal logic. And in this project we were showing landscape of Poland using many tools, films, artworks, but also planning, photographic projects, as it is usual in this project. Very often, and you see it also here, Warsaw under construction is based on one big architectural intervention, and here in this case the design of the show was prepared designed by the Butzut Architectural Office from Krakow. So you see some stuff from the show, so typical houses from communism time, when even the small private houses were typical, like in Khrushchev architecture here, or like generally speaking in Soviet bloc, they were based on the catalog projects and optimized. So. And we were, of course, in this project, we were showing how Poland is, and this discussion is moderated by middle class, and the needs of this class. So there were such subjects, of course, like gentrification, suburbs, and transformations in space. So you see this project, and also of course artworks like Jarosław Kozłowski and typical works from the 90s. Of course the context, and we were presenting a lot of like TV series and TV materials from the 90s, the paintings of Mariola Przyjemska showing how the housing is somehow squeezed in the center of Warsaw, it is now somehow squeezed in between the towers which are growing all around in the center of Warsaw. So this is it. You see also the visual identification of the project, and maybe for the end of this short presentation, I will show you something which is maybe most related from all of our projects to your exhibition, because this show was it was held in 2010 in the Association of Warsaw Architects, SARP. So there is a modernist pavilion in this kind of modern, also modern ruins somehow, because the pavilion was renovated in the 90s in a very bad way. So you see how it looks like now in the garden in the center of Warsaw. And this show, and you see here the work of Wojciech Fanko, Wojciech Zamecznik, Oskar Hansen, I think was also engaged in this project. So we were recreating in this show some designs and exhibition concepts from the 50s and from the 60s, but from one reason somehow. We were testing in this show how it can be fruitful today. Because what was interesting, and I think it is also a case of this show and the artists and collaborators, collaborations shown here, presented here, that architects, also Hansen, a group of exhibition designers also, graphic designers, photographers, poster designers, they were working in groups. So teamwork, as one of them, Zbigniew Ignatowicz said, teamwork is the necessity of our times. Difficult times, 50s, 60s, lack of materials, lack of also somehow freedom in many projects. So in many conceptual works, many teamworks, they were testing some also scientific concepts, because what could be related to your shows, to your show here, would be Dusan Komisz and Lech Tomaszewski and their kind of topologic projects were presented also then. And some also relations between this kind of based on science, scientific, architecture, exhibition design, and art. And art. So we had here this red wall. It is a kind of environmental space designed by Wojciech Fanko, artist. You see also kind of exhibition of painting by Henryk Starzewski in the middle of the photo. So this was important experience also for us, and I think that on this photo you can see also some historical part of the pavilion, so the show was finally fitted, and somehow it worked very well in that space. From our point of view, it was an interesting example, and also as in the case of this show, your show, this project was based in 95% on archives and very often on private archives found scattered in Warsaw. We were transforming very, and conservating also, very often preserving, very often bad drawings, very bad quality papers to present them in that show. Thank you very much. I think that we are too long already with Ola, but maybe it's... I have also all of our projects, so you can
thank you.